Let's continue working on Popeye the Racer Man. You know, in case anyone is thinking, you know, how much time should I invest into practice, into drawing, so that I could improve? How many hours a day, or how many minutes? I believe that it should be as long as it takes to become for you to start seeing at least a comfortable level of your drawing level. So what does that mean? How many hours? It's as many as you can. You know, there's so much time that's wasted on television, watching reruns of TV shows. I mean, I like watching stuff on YouTube once in a while, but but even if you're doing that, just not even looking at your sheet of paper, just start sketching and let's see if your mind can pick up shapes or make out shapes in those random sketches of paper, scratches or lines on the paper. The more you practice, the more time you invest in any hobby or skill that catches your interest, the more time you put into it, the sooner you'll master it. So, as a kid, like many other kids, just drew whenever there was that. Gets a crayon and pencil. I don't believe that I was an artist. I still don't feel like an artist. I just feel like more like a businessman that creates. I'm probably working on the title of becoming an artist. And to me, an artist is I think someone who creates art that person has pretty much complete control over, quality control over. And I don't believe fame is something that will ultimately confirm your status of being an artist. I know some tattooers, some illustrators that do do their stuff real low key. They don't. They haven't been picked up by like a big illustrating firm or a big movie studio. Because these guys just are so caught up in creating that they probably see their portfolio as the the impression that they want to leave on in this world. And I've seen tattooers where cool story. I was at a convention once, and I had seen a client sit down in the chair of Robert Hernandez, awesome tattooer, just a brilliant artist. His artwork is macabre, realistic, a lot of black and gray. But he had his client sit down in the chair, and he had shaved them from wrist to elbow, basically. And he told them from this part of the arm to this part of the arm, it's 500, from here to here, 800, I believe, from here to here, from wrist to elbow, 1300, and the guy answered, Robert, money is not an object. And then he said, Robert had asked him, well, what do you want to get? And the dude said, you're the artist, do what you want. And he came out with this amazing skull looking thing. And to me, that's an artist. It's getting a piece from someone's mind. That's all. You're getting that tattoo or that piece or that creation from that person because you've seen their work. You have a comfort or a trust in their work or reputation. Me in the meanwhile, I'm not a big, I don't like tattooing as much as I do. I don't like tattooing as much now as I did before. And the reason is, especially in Los Angeles, it's just boatloads of tattooers, and my most recent client, which I gave up on, says, I think I'm getting this design tattoo or this one, And as soon as he gave me the second option, that's when I decided I'm not going to tattoo this person. I just told him that I was busy for the week. And I'm always busy. And because I always find something to do, always find something to create. But I'm not there to be I'm not there to be your buddy and confirm whatever idea you have in your head that may look cool, or a tattoo that may look cool on you, or sexy, or awesome. You know, if you like what I make, well, just it'd be cool if you realize that just about everything that I do now, I know that I do it with a lot of care, and planning, because if someone hired me for a tattoo or a painting or some other commission, and I just charged a crazy amount of money and half-assed it, that would be real bad for business. So almost beat up this client that was on a tattoo. He was a tattoo apprentice at one of the shops I was at. And before I started tattooing him, he said, hey dog, I want you to do your best on this stuff. You know, be real careful. And the reason that got me angry is because obviously this idiot had not been paying attention to my work already for the few months that we had already been working together. I didn't rush anyone to work, and for him to tell me, like, be careful, or that's it, to me it was like saying, you know, all your other shit, you know, you rush it, but not my tattoo. And I'm like, dude, I still did a tattoo, still did my best, but I told him, don't make a stupid request if you know that I take this stuff seriously. So I forget where I was going with this conversation. But let's draw. Sit down and draw.